This is Tiananmen Square, the largest military square in the world. It's been in use since ancient times, and it still is in use today. You might recognize it because it's one of the world's most iconic sites.
This is Living Local, Traveling Global with Kelly Farrow, featuring United States Tour Operators Association member Wendy Wu Tours in China. The three cities that we visited on our Wendy Wu Tours itinerary, a United States Tour Operators Association member, each surprised me in that they were so modern and at the same time so ancient. To me, this duality is what makes China so unique. In Beijing, I could see China's history come alive.
The Tiananmen Square is the most important area, as a military square from the ancient times to today.
Our guide Randy took us into the Forbidden City, and I'm glad I had on good walking shoes. This palace is over 180 acres.
We're in the Forbidden City, and we've been walking for around 15 minutes, and we're still not even yet in the inner court. I can see why this is the biggest palace in the world.
You can almost see one of the many emperors that called this place home walking through the grounds with his consorts and advisors in tow. It was labeled forbidden at the time because no outside people were allowed in. But now, as you can see, that certainly is not the case. There were many halls within the grounds, some of which were built for leisure and others for work. And a huge number of servants and workers lived on the premises to attend to the imperial family's every need. Go, even if just to admire the architecture and artwork. Beijing's hutongs are the traditional residential area of the city, where all the houses have a courtyard.
很开心，很幸福，也很悠闲。悠闲，开心，幸福。
We're in the Hutong District, which is actually one of my favorite neighborhoods in Beijing, and we're getting a tour of it by rickshaw, which you have to do if you come here. It's super fun. And the streets are really narrow, so we're kind of weaving in and out and seeing all the local life as it goes by.
These neighborhoods once made up the majority of Chinese cities, but now are being paved for new developments. Luckily, Beijing has protected several of its hutongs, and our USTOA member Wendy Wu Tours arranged for us to dive right into the hutong culture. We were welcomed into one of the traditional hutongs for a Chinese lunch and musical performance with the matriarch of the family, Mrs. Fan.
这是我的家里，对，然后我们是主要是我们家是奥运家庭，有些外国过来我们家来了解中国文化，然后来品尝老北京的家常菜。
Tai Chi is a very significant part of the Chinese culture, and I noticed it right away with many of the older generation practicing it publicly in parks. I was able to have a one-on-one with a Tai Chi master in Beijing, where he tried to teach me the basic tenets of Tai Chi through example. Strength, stillness, and concentration. Once I got into the flow of it, I could see how this would not only be good for your body, but also for your mind. Shanghai, the most modern of the three cities that we visited on our journey with Wendy Wu Tours, still values its ancient heritage with its very pastoral parks.
This is the People's Park, and here it's so quiet, serene, and well-manicured, you'd never realize that you're in the middle of bustling downtown Shanghai.
I saw more Tai Chi, music, and a very zen atmosphere.
We're in the old town of Shanghai, and you can see it all around in the architecture here. There's all sorts of stalls and crafts and so much going on. Let's go shopping.
Shanghai's old neighborhood is a reconstructed hutong, which now sells souvenirs and traditional crafts and products. Though it was a bit more touristy, I still loved walking through the streets, admiring the architecture, and taking a break from the big city in the Yew Garden. In a country that is developing so rapidly, it is wonderful to see that there's still an active and appreciation for the ancient culture. Jian keeps its ancient culture alive as well, with the most prominent physical reminder being its well-maintained city walls. These walls used to guard this previous capital city, and now they are just as beautiful from below as they are from on top.
This is Xi'an, and a great way to see it is by biking on top of the city walls.
I preferred to take in the city from above. The traditional culture of Xi'an is also alive through its people. A walk in the park allowed us to meet many of the older generations, staying fit, playing ping pong, or performing Tai Chi. I even was able to get in a quick game, though I was quite obviously outmatched. My favorite embodiment of traditional Chinese culture, however, has to be the dancing ladies. It is a phenomenon that has swept the country. Older women meet in parks and dance together.
They call it square dancing, and there's one leader choreographing the dance to very popular songs, and everyone else, including me, follows along.
People think dancing will make your health like a sport, like a training, you know. So women, same age with my mom, they like dancing and have fun. They think, oh, my life is happy, I can dancing and I'm healthy like that. So it's really popular now.
I loved how it was free, open, and very welcoming, even to me. I personally hope this catches on in the U.S.